It's 2026 and I still see many artists struggle with one simple thing, exporting from After Effects. So in this tutorial, I'll show you my preferred way to do it, then dig a bit deeper into the personal settings and small decisions that actually make the difference between it just rendered and it looks correct on the platform you are posting to. We'll look at a few lesser known export options and I'll show you a neat copy and paste trick straight from After Effects. If you stick until the end, I'll show you also my recommended workflow for exporting a GIF and a compressed video with an embedded alpha channel. The whole thing is totally free, no plugins, no subscriptions, no money involved, unless you count a like and subscribe, which is also totally optional. So, let's find out what is the best way to export a movie from After Effects in 2026. So to illustrate it, why won't we start with file export, right? This is where you go to when you want to export stuff. And you probably want to choose this command, add to render queue, or maybe add to Adobe Media Encoder queue. I will speak about both of these in a moment. You can also find both of these options under the composition menu. And over here, you also have some keyboard shortcuts if you want to memorize them. But let's just for a moment hang on the export menu item and talk about those two items. Maxon Cinema 4D Exporter, which is a great way if you want to export your scene. This is basically what I did over here. So I started up with this scene that includes the 3D camera tracker. Notice that we have this camera over here, as well as a floor with a grid just to test that everything is okay, and few null objects. If you want to continue and build it inside Cinema 4D, then you can actually export a C4D file directly from After Effects. All you need to do is go to the export menu and then choose Maxon Cinema 4D Exporter. Then you'll need to open it inside Cinema 4D, which is what I did over here. Add your elements and obviously you can now render them straight from Cinema and composite them inside After Effects, which is exactly what I did. So I'll switch back to After Effects and close this scene and preview the one that we're actually going to use in order to export it. Now, before we are going to do it, I'll go back to the beginning, go back to the project menu and quickly talk about this option, export the entire project as a Premiere Pro project. This is something that you can do. So if you want, you can save it wherever you want. I'm just going to save it over here near all the other files. And then if I'll open it inside Premiere Pro, let's go to Open Project, navigate to the same directory that I've just saved from After Effects, click Open. It will tell me that some of the effects that I'm using are not available inside Premiere Pro. I can tell it not to show again. I just want to show you that you can actually build a Premiere project from After Effects in case you need it. So if I'll double click over here and maximize all of the layers here, you can see that I have access to everything that I've rendered from Cinema 4D, including all the layers that I added inside After Effects. And I can, if I want, continue to mess with them over here. But of course, this is not the topic of this lesson. So let's return back to After Effects. And now, instead of going to File, Export, and select one of these guys, I'm actually going to go to the Composition menu and add this to the Render queue, because this is my preferred way of working. Now, by default, After Effects is going to offer you best settings, which for most cases, this is what you want. Notice that if you want, you can send it to queue inside Adobe Media Encoder directly from here. So you don't need to go to the window command. The advantage is that whatever you're going to set in the settings options here is going to carry on with the file. I'll show you in a moment another way to work. But for now, I'm just going to change the output model to high quality, which is my master file. So this is going to produce a QuickTime ProRes file that I can now use again in any other editing system or back inside After Effects as a source. Now, before I'll carry on, I'll click on this drop-down menu and I'll select Render next to Project File. Over here, you have some tokens that you can use, so go ahead and play with them, but this will make sure that this file is right next door to where my project lives. Now, if I want a web delivery as well, I'll click on the plus which is going to add another output model, and 15 megabits per second is great for any web delivery. But let's say that I want to make it even higher in terms of quality, assuming I'm working with a 4K size, I'll click again on this plus, and from this list, I'll select 40 megabits per second. And that's it, I'm all set. Notice that now if I click on render, it's going to process everything once and spit out three files. Once the process has been finished, I can open up the output model settings, click in order to see the file, but I don't even need to look at it from here. If I want, I can just open up any one of these, or actually just select the name output model and drag and drop it back into the project panel. And this means that I can now use this one as a source if needs be. Now, let's say that I want to send it to Adobe Media Encoder to render in the background. Well, if this is the case, you can of course duplicate the entire thing, or you can go over here to the composition menu and add this to Adobe Media Render Queue. But my favorite way of working is to actually select the comp that I want to render, then drag and drop it. I'm still holding the mouse. I'll switch to Media Encoder, which is running in the background on my machine, and I'll let go over here. And this is going to do the same thing. Also notice it's going to save a snapshot of it. So you can see where it says output file. If I click on it, you'll see that inside this output file, there is an After Effects project, which is exactly what the project looks like when I dragged it over here. Now, I won't render it in this case, but if you want, you have more options and more codecs. And I will get back to Media Encoder in a moment to show you something unique. But now let's talk about how to save a frame, just a still image from After Effects, as well as the other way around. So back inside After Effects, let's say that I want to save this image to Photoshop. Now I have a few options. The first one is to go to the Save Frame As and choose File, which is going to bring this to the render queue, and it will take the current settings. So just make sure that you are setting your comp to full, or of course you can change the default, and then it will speed up a Photoshop file. I'll do this just for the sake of demonstration. I'll save it on the desktop and I'll hit render. Now I'll return back to this composition. And I'll go to the composition menu again, but this time I'll go to Save Frame As Photoshop Layers. I'll point it to the same location, the desktop. I'll click Save, and After Effects is going to tell me that I'm using track mats and blending modes, which are not available inside Photoshop. So it will try its best to replace them with something that works. However, if I click OK and switch to Photoshop and then open up first the frame that I rendered using the Save As image, this is just a flattened file, but I don't have access to the individual layers. Compare this to the one that I saved directly from After Effects, which is actually a reflection of the After Effects timeline. Now, again, it won't look identical due to the fact that some of the blending modes as well as the track mats are not available inside Photoshop. Photoshop basically doesn't have track mats, so we'll need to rebuild this if we want to use it. But this is a quick way if we need this functionality. I'll switch back to this version, and let's say that I'm going to change something here. So I'll quickly apply a global hue correction just to make it different and ugly. Now I'll select everything and I'll go to the edit menu and choose copy to copy this information. Back inside After Effects, I'm expecting to be able to paste this, but I can't. And the reason is that the clipboard is not being shared between Photoshop and After Effects. And if this is something that you need, there is an extension that you can look at. And this is Copy Pasta by Plug and Play. The link is down below. This is a paid extension and it just does what it says on the tin. It is copying things from After Effects or pasting stuff from the clipboard. So if I click paste now, I'm going to get the image that I have in the clipboard inside a composition ready to be used. And I can do the same thing if I want to send something from After Effects to Photoshop or any other application. Just click on copy. This is now in the clipboard. I can switch now to Photoshop. And let's say that I want to rebuild this. I now can paste the image from the buffer and use it as a reference. Now, there is, of course, another free alternative. If you need the one-way direction from After Effects to other applications, and this is, of course, Video Copilot FX Console. So, of course, just click on the keyboard combination that you defined, and over here you have this option to copy it to the clipboard, as well as save to PNG and save to JPEG. But this just gives you the export option. You can't paste it from a different application. Finally, let's talk about export a GIF file as well as a movie with an alpha channel embedded. And for that, I'm going to open up another composition. In this case, I have a background which is transparent and I can toggle the transparency, but it's going to be very difficult to see what we have here. So I'm just going to switch it for a black background, but those pixels behind are transparent. So if we want, we can keep those transparent pixels. First of all, we can use, of course, the GIF format or the GIF, depending how geeky you want to sound. So I'm just going to use the same trick I showed you before. I'll drag this composition a little bit outside of its place, then switch to media encoder and drop it over here. I'm not going to render this skateboard one, so I might as well remove it from the queue. Over here inside Media Encoder, you have the ability to render an animated GIF. But I'm here to tell you this is going to create something which is going to disappoint you. So you better off render it as an MPEG-4 file or an H.264 and then convert it later to a GIF. And I'll show you in a moment how to do it. But at the same time, I'll render the MP4 file. Let's also render a file with an alpha channel, with a transparency. So one way to work is to use the QuickTime and then choose from the list the flavor that you want. Let's go with this one. And then if you want, you can click on the settings here and modify them. But this is going to create a huge file, which is going to be impossible to embed at any website. Instead, you're better off using the WebM file format. And the way to get this WebM codec to appear is to install it via Adobe Exchange. So the link is down below. It is totally free and it will show up in both Premiere and Media Encoder. Since I'm using Media Encoder, I'm going to switch to Media Encoder right now, click on Custom. And then in this case, I need to make sure I'll change this one to none in terms of field type. And I need to include the alpha channel with the render. You can also export captions if you have them, as well as audio. I'm just going to leave myself with the video alone. And then for the output name, I'll make sure that it is sitting on the desktop in this case and click OK. And now I can launch both of those files. First, let me show you how to convert the MP4 file to a GIF file. So this is the file that we want. And I recommend to use the GIFski application, which again is totally free. The link is underneath this video. Just drag and drop it over here and just set your dimensions. I'm just going to choose one of those options and you can see the estimated file size before you export it. Now notice that GIFs also supports alpha channel. So this is another way to work. I'm going to raise the frames per second to maybe 15 in this case, and then I'll click on convert and let it run. Then I can click on save as and save a copy on the desktop. And that's it. I can now go to the desktop and have a look at the GIF animation. And now we also have access to the WebM video that I showed you. So I'm just going to double click on it, and it's going to open up with Google Chrome by default. And just to prove to you that this actually have an embedded alpha channel, I'll right click and choose inspect to see the elements of the video. And then over here, I'm just going to look for the background element, and let's add blue for the background just to prove that this is indeed embedding the alpha channel inside. And this means that I can use this file inside any website. Most cases, you probably want to go with something smaller, but there you have it. The most efficient ways to export your creations from After Effects, whether it's for web delivery, final delivery, or just a quick snapshot for design or review. Now that you know how to get things out properly, make sure to watch my lesson about how to bring stuff in. That way, we close the full circle and your workflow finally makes sense from start to finish. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again in the next one.